Thank the chairman. The 299-page Democratic majority report mentions the Intelligence Community Inspector General Michael Atkinson on pages 26, 33, 138, 140, and 143. Mr. Goldman, you were present for the October 4, 2019 transcribed interview of the Inspector General Michael Atkinson, correct?
Yes.
On pages 53 to 73 of that transcribed interview, the Inspector General's testimony confirms the following: that the whistleblower made statements to the Inspector General under penalty of perjury that were not true and correct. That the whistleblower first made statements in writing under penalty of perjury that were not true and correct. The whistleblower then made statements under penalty of perjury that were not true and correct in his or her verbal responses to the Inspector General's investigative team. Because of the whistleblower's statements in writing and verbally to the Inspector General that were neither true, correct, or accurate, pages 53 to 73 of that sworn testimony reveal that the Inspector General was not able to answer any questions, none from me, about the whistleblower's contact or communication with Chairman Schiff's staff, of which Mr. Goldman is a member. Mr. Castor, do you remember anywhere in this 299-page report that makes reference to the fact that when the whistleblower started this inquiry, he or she did so by making statements under penalty of perjury that were neither true or correct in writing, and then did so again verbally?
I don't remember that.
After the Inspector General testified on October 4th, and after media reports revealed that the whistleblower and Chairman Schiff did not disclose their prior contacts or communications with one another, the whistleblower contacted the Inspector General to explain why he or she made statements under penalty of perjury in writing and verbally that were not true, correct, and accurate. Mr. Castor, is that communication from the whistleblower to the Inspector General to explain prior inconsistent statements reflected anywhere in the 299-page report? On October 2nd, Chairman Schiff's spokesman, Patrick Boland, acknowledged publicly that the outlines of the whistleblower's accusations against the president had been disclosed to the House intelligence staff and shared with Chairman Schiff. Mr. Castor, is that disclosure and Mr. Boland's admission of that disclosure anywhere in this report?
I don't remember seeing it.
It's not. I think all members of Congress should be held accountable during this impeachment process. And to that end, if I have made any false statements about the whistleblower or the Inspector General's testimony today, then I should be held accountable. The way to do that would be to release the Inspector General's testimony, or even just pages 53 to 73. I would add that there's nothing in those pages that would in any way identify or place at risk the whistleblower's identity, nor would it reveal any information that in any way relates to, much less jeopardizes, national security. Look, maybe there's a believable explanation for why the whistleblower made statements that weren't true or accurate about his contact or her contact with Chairman Schiff in writing and then again verbally. Maybe there's a good explanation for why the words Congress or Congressional Committee was confusing or not clear to the whistleblower. Maybe there's a good explanation for why the whistleblower also misled the Inspector General in writing on August 12th by stating, "I reserve the option to exercise my legal right to contact the committees directly," when the whistleblower had in fact already contacted Chairman Schiff's committee 2 weeks before he or she wrote that. Maybe there's a believable reason why Chairman Schiff was not initially truthful about his staff's communications with the whistleblower. Maybe there's a good reason that explains all of these statements in writing and verbally that just weren't true and correct. Maybe there is, but there is no good reason for voting to impeach and remove from office an American president without allowing a single question to be asked of a single witness to get an explanation for why the Inspector General was not told the truth about contacts between the whistleblower and Chairman Schiff. The bottom line is we should all be held accountable, and next November, every member of the House will be asked this question: did you vote to impeach the president without allowing any investigation into why the whistleblower that started it all did so by making statements in writing and verbally under penalty of perjury that were not true? Democrats may not care if that question ever gets answered, but the voters will. I yield back.